The Celebrate Life Festival has already a long-term history. We had already 14 Celebrate Life Festivals in Germany, in Europe, and it became a huge consciousness event, like a festival conference type event. And this is the first year that Celebrate Life comes to the US. It's a meeting point for social innovators, for people who want to combine their inner practice with their external cultural contribution, want to have a kind of a deeper spiritual practice as well. The theme of this year's festival is restoring a fragmented world. And what does that mean? Fragmentation, in a way, limits our collective intelligence, limits our capacity to collaborate, but also limits the regeneration of the whole system. So if a human being is part of nature, is part of the planet, is part of the emotional and mental landscape that we create together, so the fragmentation reduces our mutual intelligence, whereas integration and the healing and integration of trauma and fragmentation actually unleashes collective intelligence, the capacity to collaborate, the flow of information within the human system, and it also helps us to restore the global immune system. I believe collective trauma and traumatization reduces the functionality of our global immune system. And the more we restore our own life and our cultural life around us, we create a higher coherence. And I believe that's the function that we need in order to restore the global immune system, which helps us to regenerate the whole system that we live in. Our own life becomes more sustainable, but also our global health and the way we treat climate change and we treat many other issues that are global issues will be much more effective and will be reinforced. So Celebrate Life usually has kind of a morning event at where we all meet, and we have a keynote, an inspirational speaker, and then we have panels, dialogues, we have group work, and then in the afternoons usually we have a variety of workshops where people can experience deep aspects of themselves or their cultural work come together. And then in the evening we have toning meditation, which is a collective meditation that helps us to increase our coherence. And then in the evening we have simply kind of a creative program, artists, dance events, music bands. The most exciting part about the festival is that we come together with like-minded people that have a cultural calling, that have a calling to contribute something meaningful to our cultural process, but that it's a meeting point of very creative, innovative people that are in a way kind of smelling the cultural change where the future meets us. And I think when we integrate where the past kind of blocks us in a way to go forward, or where our unintegrated past feels like a break, we also need to smell where the future appears. So we need to have both. And I think the exciting part about Celebrate Life is that we deal with both aspects. We take the past with us that is still unintegrated and hurt, and we kind of create an environment where the future can become tangible and palpable for us, so that it's both. And I believe where the past and the future meet, there is presence. So presence allows us to create an emergent society. And if our society can be emergent, which means that we tap into the real future of life, I think that's a very exciting cultural experiment, and I think that's also a very exciting hub for all kinds of cultural innovations to go out into the world.